Hey there, Mike here from Amsterdam with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. And we're starting off with Replit Agent 3. It's pretty incredible in my testing so far. Okay, before we get into it, I wanted to thank Adobe for hosting a really good creator meetup out here at IBC in Amsterdam. They gave me a ring light. Wow, that's really bright. Now, let's get to Matt Palmer's tweet here. He said there are 5 big features with Replit Agent 3. I think there's a lot more, but longer runtime is one of the big headlines. Self-testing is huge because now mistakes get made less and less because the agent can test and it can actually generate its own agents, among other features that Matt goes into in detail in his post. Now, you'll see over here, I have been building a Reddit reader, a very simple Reddit reader that can take all my favorite subreddits, and I can add more here, and give me the summaries. Now, what is more, these have thousands of comments on. I can actually unfold these. This is all using a Reddit OAuth app, and look at that. Even though some of the posts are quite long, they're nicely nested, and I've got everything ready to read, and this app works on mobile. It was all made by Reddit Agent 3, or I should say, Replit Agent 3. I'm getting confused there between the R's. Anyway, I think Agent 3 is fantastic. I've also added other features. Not only now do I have ad-free reading of Reddit, which I've always really wanted, but I've also got this fantastic AI feature I built in using the agent, where I can summarize sentiment on any subreddit for, say, the last day. We'll let this run. You can see it's powered by Gemini 2.5 Flash, and it runs over all of the posts made in the last day in this subreddit, and it will give me a nice little summary. And I can run this for any Reddit. I can even add my own Reddits to the top kind of favorites bar. And look at that. Over the day, it featured a broad array of tech content, and it goes into everything from Kotlin to Python to TypeScript. This is really good stuff. Now, I can add another subreddit if I want. So I can go ahead and I can do, say, r/vibe coding or something like that. And look at that, it actually adds it. And here we go, right down here, I've now got vibe coding posts. What I can't do at the moment is delete these Reddits. So let's go over to my lovely Replit Agent 3, and we'll say, I'd like the ability to remove subreddits from my faves bar at the top, please. Now, that's a really simple prompt, and you'll see Replit Agent 3 goes to work. It definitely works harder, in my opinion. It searches, it finds what it needs, and it's really good. Let's see what happens here. There we go. I'll add the ability to remove subreddits from the favorites bar. Let me examine the subreddits tab component to understand how it works. Now, one thing I will say is, since using Agent 3 inside Replit, it is moving things out into different files a lot more, not writing one long big file worth of code, which is terrible. So more and more, this is the thing I've been pushing for a lot, is to have agents and vibe coding tools to be autonomous and do the things for us, not expect us as vibe coders to know the best practices. Now, as you can see, it's planned what it's going to do. It's now editing the pages it needs. Now you'll see it's actually going to go ahead and test this functionality to make sure it's working. Now you can see the agent is autonomously clicking through and finding out how to remove those subreddits to make sure it added a good feature to my Reddit reader tool. While it's testing away there, I can actually go into Reddit and look, I can actually get rid of subreddits just like that. Actually, the feature is working perfectly. I can add in something, so I can add in r/anthropic, like so. Now I've got the Anthropic subreddit, but again, if I want, it's just hovering over a favorite subreddit and deleting that. Now notice it actually identified an issue while working on this. The hover only remove buttons don't work on mobile devices. This is the cool thing about Agent 3 being really on it with things like this. Since it's a mobile first app, I need to fix this. Let me update it so that the buttons are always visible and touch friendly. Now, while it made a mistake in the first instance, the fact that it's going ahead and fixing its own mistake is really cool. And look at that, it's put always visible cross buttons next to the subreddits, and it's going ahead and testing the mobile-friendly remove functionality. Now, it seems to have finished the testing. It spun my app back up. But look, again, it's found bugs in the subreddit functionality. So this Agent 3 keeps going on and finding bugs and little edge cases to clean up in my app. It's clever stuff. I do wonder how long it's going to keep doing this for and also how much it's going to cost me. But it certainly is super clever. Next up, OpenAI gave us the ability to connect MCP tools to ChatGPT. Let me show you how to do it. I can go into settings and I can go to connectors and then advanced settings and switch on developer mode. Now this is going to give me superpowers because I can hit the plus, more, and go to developer mode. And now I can add sources and go to connect more. And this is the opportunity to connect an MCP server for me. I'll go ahead and create a quick new MCP server on Zapier, and I can select any client here, including ChatGPT. Now I'll go ahead and add a tool. Let's add something from one of my Zapier tables. We'll add the Find Records tool, and now you'll see Zapier makes it easy to connect to this MCP server. Over here, I can add an icon if I like. I'm going to call it Zapier Tables MCP. I don't need to give it a description. For the URL, I'll copy and paste from Zapier this URL here. Authentication is OAuth, and of course, I trust the application. And as you'll see, ChatGPT wants to access your Zapier account to indeed use that MCP server I've just set up. I'll allow. And now look at this, Zapier Tables MCP, even with its own icon, has been added to my connectors with that one tool I made available, the Zapier Tables Find Records tool. So now with that added, I can actually go ahead into developer mode, add my Zapier Tables MCP, and say, can you please summarize some of the records in my Zapier Tables? And I've run a load of Zapier tables for testing purposes. It's looking for tools, and it says I can pull records from your Zapier tables using this tool. Could you tell me which tables you'd like summarized? And here's an experiment I did recently, the X engagement shortlist. So I'll just say summarize X engagement shortlist, please. And now you'll see it's calling the tool. Yes, that's right. This is what's been made to my Zapier Tables MCP. I will confirm it. I can remember that for the rest of the conversation if I don't want to keep confirming. And ChatGPT will use MCP now natively to do lots of work for me. Now it wants to know if I want to retrieve all records. So I'll just say yes, all records. It's calling the tool. Okay, I pulled the X engagement short records via the MCP tool, and look at this, 119 records, gives me all the details. It tells me about Elon Musk's tweet being the most viewed post and the Apple AI antitrust posts. Lots of other viral posts all summarized here. This MCP tool is working well, and now we have the ability to connect more and have unlimited MCPs working right inside ChatGPT. By the way, in the time it's taken for me to do this video, Replit Agent 3 is still working away. It actually hasn't stopped working. I might have to stop it manually so I don't get an incredibly huge bill. It's certainly very promising. It's reviewing every single functionality of my app and seemingly fixing it while I'm making this video for you. Yes, feature complete. Key features added. This is the summary coming in from the agent. Finally, just before the end of the video, my Replit Agent 3 has completed. It did a lot of updates here on my app, but I can be confident now that the checkpoint is made. 17 minutes of work was done here, and I should have a really good and solid Reddit reader ready to use. And finally, Grok got a little more fun with Grok Imagine. Now you can make videos that speak to you as well.
Subscribe to Creator Magic right now.
So there you go, a fun week in the world of AI, live here from Amsterdam. Thank you for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.